Hi, my name is Rhonda Flatas. I'm a physical therapist assistant student here at Miami-Dade College. My range of motion test for today is going to be internal rotation, and George is my patient. Hi, George. Welcome. I'm going to be measuring your motion today to see if you have any limitations with this type of movement. It's going to measure how far inward you're able to rotate the top of your arm. Okay?
Okay.
So what I'd like for you to do is I'd like for you to have a seat here. Go ahead and actually lie down for me. So the first thing I'll do is I'll put my patient in a testing position. I'm going to make sure that he's nice and relaxed. In order to get really good motion here and be able to test everything, I want to make sure that there's nothing in my way. And I want to give him a little bit of support so that his arm is level. So I'm going to take him out to abduction to 90 degrees, and I'll put the towel here to give him that level surface here. So once I've gotten him into the testing position, I'm going to take him through available range of motion so that I can see where he stops and get an idea of what the end feel is like. So I'm going to watch my patient to make sure he's doing okay. And right about there is the end of his motion. I would say that's about 85 degrees. According to the AAOS, internal rotation should be about 70 degrees. So his end feel is firm. And again, my estimation was about 80 degrees. So now that I've gotten an idea of where we're starting, I'm going to take a look at what my bony landmarks are. So my fulcrum of my goniometer is going to be centered over the olecranon process. The proximal arm, which is not going to move, is going to be parallel or perpendicular to the floor. And the distal arm, which is going to be the arm that measures the movement, is going to be along the midline of his arm using the olecranon process and the ulnar sternoid process as a guide. So I will go ahead and take an initial measurement. I need to align my goniometer again with his bony landmarks. So the fulcrum goes over the olecranon process, and we've got him at zero. Okay. So I'll remove my goniometer, take George back through the available range of motion to his endpoint. Good. Make sure that he's nice and aligned, and I'll realign my goniometer to test what his end range is. I want to be able to get low enough that I'll be able to make sure that I'm properly aligned. And he's just under 80 at 77 degrees of range of motion. So he's a little bit more than what the AAOS says is normal. So I will go ahead and return him to a comfortable position and record my results.